Sonoma Water and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers are improving habitat conditions for coho salmon, Chinook salmon, and steelhead along a 14-mile stretch of dry creek between Lake Sonoma and the Russian River. Initiated in 2012, this project so far has improved 3 miles of habitat, and by the year 2023, will accomplish 6 miles of habitat restoration. The colors on this map indicate projects that have already been completed, projects recently completed in 2018, and projects that will be completed in the future. The flow in Dry Creek originates from Lake Sonoma, a reservoir that provides drinking water for 600,000 North Bay residents, as well as flood control and recreation. A hatchery at the base of Lake Sonoma produces some 700,000 coho salmon and steelhead for release into Dry Creek and other streams in the Russian River watershed. The flow in Dry Creek is cold and clean, but moves too quickly for young salmon and steelhead. Sonoma Water and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers are improving those stream flow conditions by adding additional habitats to the floodplain of Dry Creek. This is done by constructing side channels, alcoves, adding wood and rock to the stream strategically. The improvements to habitat can be seen in this image that will show what conditions look like before habitat enhancement and then as habitats are improved. In this image, the stream flows from the left-hand side of the screen to the right. You can see the design of this channel superimposed on that dry floodplain. What the design looks like with wood added, and then finally the completed project that was finished in October of 2018. Monitoring is an essential component of the project. This crew is measuring depth and velocity of the stream to monitor conditions over time. Those surveys produce a three-dimensional model where all the survey points you see here are accurate and can be tracked over time. The performance of the projects is important to make sure that conditions are optimal for coho salmon, steelhead, and Chinook salmon. Maps are created that show those conditions and can be tracked carefully over time. One feature of the projects that seems obvious is that there is little vegetation soon after construction. Vegetation is planted strategically to improve the riparian habitat of the stream over time, as can be seen in this pre-construction to final completed project and evolution of the vegetation over time from the year 2013 to 2018. As the projects continue to mature, conditions for a variety of species will be enhanced along the riparian stream corridor. Habitat conditions are also tracked very carefully for the performance of endangered fish. Biologists dive under the stream and count fish, as well as detect the presence of tags implanted in fish. Here in this underwater video, coho salmon and a variety of other species in Dry Creek can be seen enjoying the low velocity conditions. It's an incredible indication of how well the project is working, and continued performance of the projects will be tracked and monitored for many years to come.